walking through land where every living thing is beautiful. Why does it have to end? We are calling, oh so sadly, on the whispers of the wind as we send a dying message. Time we'll call our own, living free in harmony and majesty. Take me home, take me home. There's a world where we don't have to run, and maybe there's a time we'll call our own, living free in harmony and majesty. Take me home.
Well, I went and bought myself some nukes. A nuke is a half a hive that has been split. A beekeeper was selling some nukes, so I traveled a great distance to get these bees. I went and when I came back, it was super late. So I let them set out here for a day so they get used to their surroundings. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put the hive right where I had that nuke sitting, so when the foragers come back, they will know that that's their hive. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get some of my stuff. I've been a beekeeper for 11 years now. I went and bought some nukes. A nuke is a split, and a split is like having a hive, like one of those boxes that I just picked up, and you split it in two. So you create two hives. So I traveled a great distance just to get these hives, and I didn't get back until really super late. It's like 11:30 at night. So I traveled a long ways to get these bees. It was well worth it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put that nuke inside that box. There's some frames in there. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put those frames inside that box. And I have some empty frames. And I do foundationless. Foundationless means that I let the bees comb out their own wax. I don't put pre-made mat wax in there. And I'm trying to light this smoker. It rained the day before, so everything was wet. And I didn't have anything dry, so I'm like trying to smoke it. And what that does is it calms the bees down. But I just couldn't get it lit. So I actually had to install without a smoker, which was okay. I've done that before, but so I'm going to take this safety strap off this nuke because it was strapped so I wouldn't have bees in my car. I actually took my car and transported these bees in my car. And I got some screen. What I do with this screen is that, see that little hole there on that box that's right there in front of me, that little teeny hole? What I do is I put the screen over that hole so that way I don't have robber bees going in there or yellow jackets. So that's just a little safety there that I put because it's not a strong hive right now. When it gets a little stronger, I won't put that screen there because, you know, there'll be so many bees that nothing will go in there. But right now it's vulnerable. So I'm going to take these frames out and I'm going to stick them on the south side of the box because that's the warmest spot of the hive. I don't want to put them on the north side and have that warm spot in where there's no brood. And I'm taking the outside of that frame and I'm going to put it on the inside of that box. This one here has the brood in it. You can probably see it. There's no honey on that one. You want to keep the honey on the on the outer side of the box and the brood inside the box. So they'll build the comb to the other side. But the honey, they usually store their honey stores on the outside of the box, on the edge. So I'm going to put all these frames in there. Carefully do it. See all those bees? It's beautiful, isn't it? I love it. And I have these bees on a Connex box. So I kind of climb up there on this. I gotta get a ladder and climb up there. When we build out our shop, I'll have steps going up there. It'll be inside the shop though. So I'll have steps to go up and there'll be a better roof. Right now it's just like puddled water. I do have to walk gingerly. I do walk on the outside, but since I'm installing them right there, and when I'm going to inspect, I have to gingerly walk across that because they don't like vibrations. See that? That's nice. It's beautiful. Got bees all over me. Got a bee on my leg. That's okay. She didn't be there. The smoker didn't work, so. I'm going to tighten that up a little bit. You'll see here that I'll bring a frame up and you'll see that it's empty. That means it's foundationless. And on a foundationless hive, I have to level it because bees have their own leveling system. And if I don't level it perfectly, they will cross comb. See how that's empty? They'll actually fill that out. And the reason I do that is because I want them to have healthy wax from their own self. And I want something from a different hive. And I'll bring the bees in there because nurse bees don't fly. So I have to bring them in there. The ones that are flying are the foragers.
The inner cover.
And the guards. So let's bang them in there. I don't see the queen in there, so I know she's in that box. But I will level it so I don't get cross comb. And cross comb is when they move out their wax across the frame and you can't bring each frame up. It's just a mess. And I've done that before where I didn't level it properly and it was a mess. I believe I still have the cross frames. See how I put that on there? Later I put sugar water up there, one and one. It's one cup of sugar and one cup of water with Honeybee Healthy, and I put apple cider vinegar because it helps them secrete wax so they can make the comb out better. Which in the video you'll see, well, it's kind of like the hive that's on the side there. It'll be like that, but I'll have a jar on that second, the top, I'll have a jar with holes in it. That's what has the sugar water in it. And they'll drink all that.
Like these ratchet straps. And before I ratchet, I'm trying to get that better.
I went and got a bigger piece. I usually use the wire stuff, but I'm using this stuff here. And I'll ratchet strap it to the base, which I'm using those pallets. The reason I do that is if wind blows or gets moved, it won't go anywhere. Plus it helps them when they're, it smashes it down so the air doesn't get through there, and when they're sealing it, it's better for them. I'm gonna level it now. And I do level it to where it's pointing a little bit. It's high up on the end, so when it's raining, the water will go forward. It won't puddle up to their entrance. You don't want it flat. It looks good. The next hive I did, the one that's there on the left, they were a little pissy, but I kept banging that frame around, you'll see it.
The reason
a
I do
bit.
This is because when I do
I couldn't
foundation,
get it out.
Don't
I think
level
it was really
it,
super tight on that box. I couldn't get my hive tool in there to lift it up. It wasn't as easy as this other one. But they were good bees. It was worth the drive. It was a very, very, very long drive. It was good.
That's pretty good.
I used those little door jam things to lift it up a little bit. Level it out.
Their front entrance.
And when I do a hive inspection, I'll when I go in, I always check the level. Because, you know, you do bump things around. So when I go in there and do a hive inspection, and when I close it up, I'll level it again. Make sure it's all nice and neat. Because things do settle. Things do get bumped. And I hate that water there on that Connex box. But later on, I did put a sheet there to kind of soak it up, so if they did want some water, they can lay on the sheet and suck up the water instead of drowning.
I bought these bees from, want these back.
So far, I haven't seen any bees drown in that water. And the guy wanted his boxes back, so that's another trip.
To the next one.
When I go to Central Oregon.
This over here.
By there and give them to him.
I don't like this one right here.
This is my second box, my newt box.
Wait for bees.
Newt box has four to five frames. I'm kicking that water out of there. Didn't like it.
Should put something here.
Kind of moving it over a little bit. And what I'm going to do is I put that nuke box there, and that's where the my hive box is going to be. So I put the nuke box there so they can know where their home is. So when I put the hive, the real actual hive there, they'll know that their home is there. So I just kind of move it just a few inches. It's okay to move it a few inches because they know it's there. And I have it on a Connex box because we do have bears, and so there's no way to get up there. And I'm a climber, so there's no
these guys right here.
I have no issues climbing that. I just get up on a ladder and I just hop right up.
I'm gonna put their no
problem climbing it.
Their body's on the south side, so it's
that strap there. Actually, I had to have it strapped because I transported these in my car that whole trip. I had a blanket over them just in case, but there was some bees there when I took it out the night before. There were some bees underneath there, so they were in my car the whole time, but I didn't get stung or anything. I'm going to take the safety strap off, and I'll pop that open. And you'll see that I'm going to have a hard time getting that one frame out. It was just too tight. I do have a tool where I can clamp onto that frame and lift it up, but it was down below me. It's in the Connex box and all my bee stuff. I didn't bring it with me. I should have, but I thought it would be easy to just do it this way. It got a little pissy though. A little angry, and I didn't have my smoker going. Would have calmed him down a little bit. I'm not afraid of bees. Next year, I'll split these hives if I can. I'll split them just like this. I'll make another hive. And when we have our shop built, all my hives are going to be on these Connex boxes. And it will be a little safer.
Fencing around. So right now, this is what I got. I can make it work. Put it back exactly where it was.
You can see the brood and the hive. That brood has to be in the center of that box.
Goes to the next one, and the tiny super will be
until one puts their hand on a live hive, hear her hums, witness her dances, smell her brood and honey. You will never feel what a beekeeper feels. The power to protect her is so overwhelming, you become possessed, and her loss of life is devastating. You lost a friend. Mm-hmm.